as we get older, it seems like the world gets faster, right? Faster cars, faster meals, faster internet, supposedly. But what does that mean for healthcare and AI? Buckle up, let's find out right here on UBS Trending. Hi, everyone, and welcome to UBS Trending. I'm your host for today, Lynette Jefferson, filling in for Anthony Pastore. Michelle is back from CIO, as well as Alexander from Zurich, to break down the 52-page thematic report to the most important parts in 10 minutes or less. So listen, I'm going to talk to my dear friend Michelle over here. Really want you to break this down for us. For those of us that may not have had the time to read that 52-page report, if you could just save us some time, and if there's one or two new things that we need to know about that report, what are those things? What stands out to you, Michelle? What do we need to know?
I just have to mention AI. You know, I think we've all probably heard by now about the Surging Seven, right? And these companies in the semiconductor industry that have really just driven massive gains this year. So it's really taking markets by storm. But it's kind of funny because we've actually been talking about AI for many years now. And it's a part of our enabling technologies longer term investment theme. But what I think we saw over the past year or so was this watershed moment where everyone came to recognize what AI could potentially do. Because we saw this rapid adoption of ChatGPT, right? It took just a little over a month to hit 50 million users. So that really kind of brought AI to the fore for a lot of people. And I think it's hard to predict just exactly when these kind of watershed moments happen or these inflection points happen. But that's why thematic investing can help you get exposure to some of these areas so you're prepared when they do happen, right? So I think it's been a really interesting year for AI. So very excited to talk a little bit more about that today.
All right, so from what I'm hearing, so folks need to focus on the fact that there's rapid change in AI and need to sort of keep our eye on that, but there is opportunity inside of that rapid change.
Absolutely. Okay. Technological advancement is just one of the factors that we've identified in our framework for thematic investing.
All right, love to hear it. Well, listen, I think I'm going to switch on over to Alex now. That seems to make sense because, Alex, we want to kind of hear from you to get the perspective of the investor. So would love to hear the investor's point of view. So for those investors that are out there listening to us today, talk to us about the benefit from these from thematic investing, and in particular, the trends and what would be the best approach if we as investors are looking to dabble in this theme.
Hi, Lynette and Michelle. Yes, we have identified several direct and indirect beneficiaries of artificial intelligence in our thematic guide report. But instead of trying to pick the next AI winner, we prefer getting diversified exposure across themes to help balance out extremes in performance. Diversification, whether within individual themes or across multiple themes, is key to success when investing through an economic cycle. For instance, it's been a great year for AI themes like our enabling technologies theme. But if you would have invested in a single theme like renewables, it would be a much rockier year. And next year may bring different set of drivers lifting one theme over another. Therefore, for investors who want to build a thematic portfolio, we recommend taking a diversified approach across holdings.
Yeah, okay, then that's good to hear. So diversification is still key, even though we're talking about a rapidly evolving theme and sector. So love to hear that diversification still is the recommendation and very important in your view. So wonderful. Thank you for that, Alex. Michelle, back to you. So listen, it's not just the tech sector that can benefit from AI. I think a lot of people make the mistake thinking and automatically equate AI to tech and things that are adjacent to technology. But in your view, maybe you can share with the audience, what are we missing here? What are the sectors that are poised to greatly benefit from artificial intelligence, and what should we be paying attention to?
I do think that AI will touch nearly every industry. I think, you know, in a lot of cases, it will almost become like table stakes for some of these companies out there. But when I think about some of the themes where there could be really interesting use cases for AI, you know, education is one that comes to mind, things like personalized learning. But I would be remiss if I didn't mention healthcare. You know, I said technological advancement earlier was one of the key factors underneath our framework. We also identified aging of the population as another key factor. And when you have an aging population, that's going to put more strain, more demand on an already strained healthcare system. So how can we make that healthcare, you know, system much more efficient? You know, AI is one opportunity to do that. And it's interesting because healthcare generates so much data, right? And that's what feeds AI, is data. So the data is there, it's just a matter of utilizing that to drive more efficiency gains with tools like AI. So I think healthcare is one super interesting area. You know, just personally, I had a doctor's visit the other day. It was just routine, so I'm all good over here. But I did notice in the lobby that there was a sign, right? And it said, you know, we run our scans and our imaging through an AI system for a second opinion. And it's really interesting. I think that says something about, you know, we get a lot of questions about, will AI take my job, right? And I think it's going to be a partnership for a while. Because personally, I would love AI to check my scan, but I also want the doctor to look too, right? It's kind of that partnership at the stages we're at now. But we're, in just an example, we're already seeing AI being used in healthcare every day.
Great example. So, you know, no fear of walking into the office and seeing the Terminator in there about to do an exam on you, but rather, sounds like AI can be used to supplement and enhance and create even more efficiencies when it even comes to our own healthcare. So love to hear that great example. So listen, Alex, back to you. We're slowly running out of time, but want you to bring it on home, sum it all up for us. What are the one or two key takeaways for our audience today when it comes to this particular theme?
Yeah, I mean, one point I want to highlight is that Michelle and I have only mentioned a few of the themes included in our thematic guide. There are many other thematic opportunities investors can choose. For a nice overview of each theme, I recommend checking out the one-page profiles of our themes in the second part of the guide. They really make it easy for investors to identify which themes they find most appealing.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for that. So, as always, Michelle, thank you for being with us here today in studio. Alex, thank you as well, all the way from Zurich. And thank you to the listening audience for spending time with us today. As always, for more information, visit ubs.com/views. UBS Trending is also on social media, so you can follow us on Instagram at UBS Trending for content that you wouldn't find anywhere else. And you can also check LinkedIn, Facebook, and Twitter for more. And of course, if you have any questions about your portfolio, please speak with your financial advisor. Until next time, I'm Lynette Jefferson, filling in for Anthony Pastore. Have a great day, and remember, keep your eyes on what's trending.